All right, as you can see, we've got the engine stripped down to just the block. All the pistons are taken out, which we're going to have to get new pistons. We're going to have to bore and hone the cylinders. There's quite a bit of rust in here. There's rust in the top. There's paint, scale. It's pretty nasty and pretty dirty. So, again, we're doing this overhaul kind of on the cheap. So, thanks to YouTube, I found that you can do actually electrolysis on this. And you can actually dunk these in a water bath, hook it up to a battery charger, and all this rust through electrolysis will be removed. So we're going to give this a go. So went to the local hardware store. I picked up a big 44-gallon trash can, a rubber one. Picked up some of these rods. Again, this is pretty inexpensive. And picked up this Arm & Hammer washing soda. And of course, I have my 15-amp battery charger. We're gonna dunk this cylinder head, this block, into this trash can with water and see what happens. So I'm gonna get this set up and then we'll take a look at it.
Okay, we have the engine on the crane, shop crane, and we put it in there vertically. A lot of the videos we watched, they did more of that kind of tote for parts. But you gotta have a really big one. Really big one for an engine block. So I thought if I turn it up on its side, stand it up, and basically suspend it from the crane, I'm gonna have a lot more room, and I got at least 2 inches then between the rods. So we put the four rods in, we wired them in with copper, and then all four rods are connected. And then I just clamped the positive on one of the rods, negative right on the block. And hopefully pretty soon we should start seeing some action here. So again, kind of excited. Got the battery charger. This is a 15 amp, and it's only pulling about 2 to 3 maybe right now. So we'll see what happens as this gets going. Put about 2.5 cups. This is a 44-gallon. I'm supposed to put a tablespoon per gallon. So it was about 2.5 cups of the laundry soda. And we'll come back here and visit this and check up on it and see. Right now, again, the water looks pretty clear. There's some oil and stuff coming up. But we can see down there. So we'll see what it looks like here in a couple hours. I'm going to let this go for a couple hours and we'll come back and see if we can get some of that rust. All that rust, see if we can get all that rust off this engine and clean this thing up. So it looks all nice and shiny, like where the bearings and everything were. So see what happens. Okay, so the engine's been in this solution for about an hour and a half, hour 20 minutes. And you can obviously see the rust that's coming up, the scum on the top, kind of a combination of oil and rust that's coming off the engine and collecting around the sacrificial bars of metal. So again, this seems to be working pretty good. The one thing I did do is I did put a battery in parallel with this as well. So that I have both a battery and a battery charger going on here. Battery charger's pulling, not quite 10 amps, maybe 8 amps. It's set to 15. So, you know, again, we're just using the battery as a little bit of a buffer capacitor to for the reaction. And it seems to be chugging along quite well. You can see some of the bubbling and some of the action. I don't know if you can hear that buzzing too. There's quite a bit of buzz next to the connectors, but she's definitely cooking. So we'll probably stop back later today after 4 or 5 hours, take a look. But my plan is to leave this on overnight for a full day. I may turn it down to 2 amps at night when I'm not out here. Just leave it slow cook. And So far it seems to be working. We got some greens, we got the oil, we got the rust colors. So it's definitely working for me. You can see the bubbles. Going pretty good, pretty happy with it so far. Pretty excited to see what the motor's gonna look like when I pull it here tomorrow. Okay, we just pulled the engine, the block out of the electrolysis tank. It's been in there for about 24 hours and it's looking really good. We power washed it off. This top here, where the intake manifold sit on top, this was painted with black paint and it was all loose. There's a little bit down here yet that I'm gonna have to pull up with a wire brush, but the rest of it has completely come off and I'm down to the bare metal. This in here was all rusted up because water sits in here. There's a little bit of rust in here yet. But the outside looks pretty good. This side got some grime yet. Inside looks good. This side looks pretty good. So it's converted the rust to another component and it's black. It turns it black. And so this is actually, we're gonna put this in the tank for another 24 hours, another day. We're gonna put clean water in it. We're gonna run it for another 24 hours and see. Now when I emptied this out, these rods, which takes all the abuse, were just completely disgusting. Everything absorbs to the rods. So we clean the tank out. Again, it's just water. So we're gonna fill this up with some water, put the washing soda in it to for conduct electricity, and we're gonna put this in for another 24 hours. And then we should be, all the rust should be completely gone. And we should be ready to get the cylinders ready for the new pistons. Now the one thing they did say with the electrolysis is it does not get inside these chambers because there's no electrical field in there because the rods are on the outside. This is the ground. So inside these chambers doesn't get cleaned out from the rust. So we're gonna run through, we're gonna go through that with some scrub brushes and scrub some of that out to get the jackets out. I've sprayed in there with my pressure washer. And we're going to continue to work on inside there, but for my low budget overhaul, I think we're pretty good. The other thing I did is you can't do electrolysis on aluminum. So with the heads here, this one, I was able to get the pistons out. I did some cleaning on the cams here, but again, I was kind of tired of the chemical bath and smelling like petroleum products all day. So one of the things I tried that I have really good success on with cooking and cleaning is this gold metal heat and clean. Ace Hardware sells it, or they stock it, or you can order it from Ace Hardware. You can get it online at Gold Metal Products companies. You know, it's made to clean popcorn machines. And it loosens up the carbon and sticks to it in oil and it cleans it out. And I thought, well, if it's good enough for popcorn machines that I've seen pretty black and disgusting, we're gonna try it with these aluminums because it doesn't affect, it doesn't hurt the aluminum. It's safe for all metals. And the best part about it is it's food grade quality. So your hands are, you know, you can put your hands in it. It's not gonna hurt you. And you don't smell like, again, petroleum cleaning products when you're done, like gasoline or kerosene or whatever you're using. You can see how dirty this other head is. And this isn't done, but you can tell just with it soaking in hot water, you know, 160, 180 degree water with this heat and clean and soaking in there. It took a lot of that carbon up and a lot of that burnt oil and cleaned it up. And then there's the cam that I've oiled. As opposed to this one that's black, it took all that black off.
on there. Went from that to that. So again, I highly recommend this gold metal heat and clean. And again, the reason we're using it is because, again, this is just hot water, water-soluble detergent, and it's not a harsh chemical. You can simply throw it out. You can, just like you would any hot water, flush it down a drain, disposal of it, and the cleanup is really easy. And it gives me a good starting point to degrease this engine that now I can get into some detail and get the thing cleaned up how I need to be. But so overall, I'm pretty happy with the electrolysis of the engine block and the heat and clean on the aluminum heads. This is looking like it's going pretty good. So I will get back to you and we'll show you obviously the finished product.